through.
In there for the touchdown. Coming home here in lane five. Well out in front of the field. Check touches in a time of 52.92, a new high school national record. Back to back to back to back state champion.
NET Sports, Nebraska's home for championship sports, is live from the Bob Devaney Sports Center in Lincoln, Nebraska. For the 2018 NSAA State High School Volleyball Championships, and we close out our long day of championships in Class A as the Mustangs of Millard North, ranked and seeded number one, take on the number two seed and number two ranked Thunderbolts of Lincoln, Pius the 10th. And hello again, everyone. One final time from here at the Bob Devaney Sports Center, along with Kathy Wieskamp. I'm Larry Putney. It's great to have you with us one final time as we get ready to crown our sixth and final state champion tonight. Lincoln Pius taking on Millard North. Millard North has certainly been here before, but I think it's been a long time since we've seen a Lincoln team in the finals of Class A.
Definitely. It's been 17 years since a Lincoln team. Pius, we have seen in finals. They've got seven state champions in Class B, but here they are in Class A. And so it's been 17-year drought. Millard North would like to make sure it doesn't come back to Lincoln, that's for sure. They would like to have their second state championship in two out of the last 3 years. But Pius is here. They knocked off Marion in a thriller five set, right. 15-12 in that fifth set. So they're ready to go and would like nothing more than to bring that back to Lincoln.
17 years since a Lincoln team has been in the final, 20 years since a Lincoln team has walked away with the state championship trophy. So let's take a look at these two teams and from where they come. Of course, Millard North in Millard, Nebraska. No surprise there, just outside of Omaha. Lincoln, Pius the 10th, straight down A Street, about 56th and A. They both made their way here to the Devaney Sports Center tonight. This is how they got here, who they beat to get here. The Thunderbolts knocked off Millard South 3-0. And then, as you said, that five-set thriller beat Marion last night. Millard North, well, they really cruised their way here. They've swept both Papillion La Vista South and Gretna. And with more on the long Lincoln drought, let's go down courtside to Ryan Mix.
That's right, guys. As you mentioned, it's been 20 years since a Class A Lincoln team has won a state championship, and Lincoln Pius the 10th has a great opportunity tonight. I don't think we could ask for a better match to close out the evening in Class A. Millard North, Pius 1-2. Pius comes into this match nationally ranked in the top 20 by USA Today and Max Preps. And between the two teams, there are 11 players that we will see on the floor who are committed to play in college. Lincoln Pius the 10th is undefeated since September 15th, winning over 25 matches in a row. And Millard North, this is their third consecutive year in the state title, hoping to lean on that experience playing in the Bob Devaney Sports Center.
Should be a good one. Thank you very much, Ryan. The Class A state championship will close us out here at the Bob Devaney Sports Center. Come back. It's going to be the Mustangs or the Thunderbolts taking home the championship right here on NET Sports.
Have you ever wondered what happens to soybeans after they're harvested? Every year, soybean farmers invest a portion of their soybean revenue to fund research, marketing, and promotion, which is called the Nebraska Soybean Checkoff. 80% of the harvested soybeans are crushed into soybean meal that's used to feed poultry and livestock. The other 20% is made into soybean oil that's used for cooking oil and biodiesel. To learn more about the Nebraska Soybean Checkoff, NebraskaSoybeans.org.
Let's talk about public power for a second. Did you know Nebraska is the only state in the nation served entirely by public power electric utilities? Community-owned utilities mean Nebraskans are working for Nebraskans. Just another way your electric utility shows how public power works for you. Let's talk about public power for a second. Did you know Nebraska's electric utilities are governed by locally elected or appointed boards and councils? This means you have a voice in the decisions made by your local utility. Just another way your electric utility shows how public power works for you.
Participating in multiple Nebraska high school activities has taught me the value of teamwork.
I learned how to be a strong leader among my peers.
We set goals as a team and work hard to accomplish them.
I strive to excel not only in the classroom, but on the playing field.
The Nebraska School Activities Association, providing opportunities in 25 activities for our member high schools. NSAA activities, the other half of education.
The values that Methodists bring is family.
It's important going through school that you're not just a number, that you're a face and that you're a name to a teacher. And so I loved the small class sizes.
What it means to me is that I found my foundation where I can build on my passion and I can embrace something new in my life. It is a place where I know that I'm supposed to be.
Number one versus number two in Class A. And now for the introduction of our athletes, let's go to Steve Lemon.
Welcome to Championship Saturday in the Bob Devaney Sports Center for the 2018 Nebraska School Activities Association State Volleyball Championships. The Class A State Championship features the Millard North Mustangs and the Lincoln Pius the 10th Thunderbolts. The NSAA is proud to recognize our premier corporate partners for their outstanding support of NSAA activities. U.S. Bank, Farmers Mutual Insurance, the Nebraska Chiropractic Physicians Association, Nebraska Orthopedic and Sports Medicine, and CHI Health St. Elizabeth. And now for the introduction of the players and coaches. Here are the Millard North Mustangs. Number one, Haley Moshka. Number two, Allie Kearns. Number three, Emmy Grant. Number four, Molly Plain. Number seven, Lauren Macheski. Number eight, Emma Altman. Number nine, London Emmons. Number 10, Marissa Solber. Number 11, Eve Fountain. Number 13, Emma Grunkmeyer. Number 14, Paige Holdsworth. Number 15, Izzy Lukens. And number 16, McKenna Rock. The assistant coaches are Megan Evans, Monty Sheaf, Rick Hughes, and Lindsey Grant. The head coach is Lindsey Peterson. Here are the Lincoln Pius the 10th Thunderbolts. Number two, Cora Thomas. Number four, Grace Goki. Number five, Emma Gable. Number six, Riley Kenobi. Number seven, Josie Gable. Number eight, Morgan Christensen. Number nine, Lauren Tobenheim. Number 10, Miriam Miller. Number 11, Kylan Seelock. Number 12, Alexis Markowski. Number 13, Caitlin Ventura. Number 14, Delaney Hum. Number 15, Anna McLean. And number 16, Carly Rodaway. The assistant coaches are John Allward, Zach Savela, Josie Provette, Claire McDermott, and Brianna Golka. The head coach is Katie Wenz. Our officials this evening are Chuck Taylor and Megan Jennings. The bench official is Tim Solman. Our line judges are Robin Kuhlman and Tegan Muller. And now, let's play state championship volleyball!
State championship on the line here in Class A. Number one, Millard North, the Mustangs taking on second-ranked Pius 10th Thunderbolts. Millard North is led by head coach Lindsey Peterson, her seventh season overall. 179-93. Peterson spent 4 years at Burke High School as an assistant head coach before taking over at Millard North. She has been in this state championship game for three consecutive years. Won it in 2016, runner-up in 17, and here in 18. There's the head coach of Lincoln Pius, 10th, Katie Wenz, taking over for a longtime and successful head coach, Jake
Jake Moore,
yeah. I was about to say Meyer.
Jake Moore has been a great mentor for Katie. She said after the match last night, he was very calming factor for me. At different times, I had to give him a look, and he just said, just breathe. You got it. So I'm sure he will be watching with close intent. And Katie will be breathing tonight.
Laney Hum starts it off. Run the quick middle. And the kill in the middle, one zip right away for the Mustangs as the kill from McKenna Ruck.
Ruck, just a junior, but again, one of those players we feel like we've been seeing here every year, and she does great things, works hard in that middle position.
Outside again of the kill. Again, McKenna Ruck. Outside, junior, 6'2".
Great high contact point. Ruck's really one of those dominating attackers.
Outside, blocked back on the swing by Taubenheim. The other side, Taubenheim got a hand on it. Second touch, not down. Swing in the middle and the kill by Christensen.
Christensen, that middle, takes it, turns hard off the block. Just a great shot to that right back corner.
Right down the middle, good dig in the back row for the Thunderbolts. Taubenheim off the block, good coverage by Christensen. Push back out to Taubenheim. And a nice dig for the Mustangs. Joust at the net. Won by Emmy Grant.
Just a very fast paced. Everybody's reacting, moving quick here. Grant right up there to meet that ball at the net.
Off the tape. Kept alive by Pius. One hand over by Markowski, and Markowski gets the kill.
Here you get a chance to see that again. Just good hang time. Markowski just sticks that fist out and pops it right back over.
Middle swing off the hands of Gable. And Grant again with the kill. Emmy Grant. Senior middle, 6'1", headed to Northwest Missouri State next year. Terrific blocker as well. On the slide, long on the swing from Markowski. Yep, they're gonna say touch. Yep. Off the hand of a Mustang. Markowski with the kill.
She waits a little bit, has to kind of adjust, but catches the fingers, that high hand shot.
Tip try is out, and we're all even at four here in set one. Taubenheim now back to serve. Aggressive swing of the block, and it's down.
Great job there by Hum. Solid look at the hand, press in. Great celebration.
Off the hands of McLean. Free balled over, opportunity here for Millard North. Push to the pin. Good, aggressive swing, a nice cut and a kill by Paige Holdsworth.
Holdsworth, one-on-one situation. She comes firing in, drives that right hard through to the floor.
Playing with the touch, not down. Into the net, called on Pius. Point for Millard North. They're up by two. Touched by Hum, not down. Out of the back row, aggressive swing and a kill again. McKenna Ruck off to a fast start.
Ruck, they like to use her in the back row. She's just a versatile player. Here they can utilize and add one more element to their offense.
McKenna Ruck was getting looks from Wyoming and Illinois, several other schools, and she's going to stay at home and play at UNO. Blocked there by Grunkmeyer, who is committed to Iowa. She committed to Iowa as a freshman. 4-zip run here for the Mustangs.
Great reach there, an adjustment with the hands by Grunkmeyer.
And the ace. Ace by Eve Fountain, and that'll force a timeout from Katie Wentz. Right off the tape, and the ace. Nine-5 here early on. Time to take a look back at last year's Class A title game.
The number one ranked Marion Crusaders faced the Millard North Mustangs for the 2017 Class A title. Millard North took the first set, which fueled the fire for Marion setter Lily Heim, who ended the match with a total of 51 set assists, the second highest in tournament history. Marion came back on top in the next three sets with their unstoppable offense to win their eighth volleyball championship.
Runner-up last year in 2017. They won it the year before in 16. This is the 23rd year that the Mustangs have been at the state tournament. 28th overall for Pius 10th. And another ace, back-to-back aces. Eve Fountain, the junior outside hitter.
43 aces this season, led the team. So she is tough back there at that service line.
6-zip run.
Wow.
Outsiders, Hum fires away. Brought back in, kept it alive. Markowski in the middle gets the kill.
Markowski just steady and consistent. Great effort here by Millard North. They gave Pius the ball in a good position to be aggressive with their attack.
So that ends the 6-0 run for Millard North. Swing is long.
Out of system, aggressive swing, just missing the mark.
Through the block, the kill by Holdsworth.
Holdsworth took advantage. The block wasn't closed, wasn't together, and she fires it right through. Just a powerful attacker. Coach says one of those players that just continues to develop each year. We feel like she's getting better in growth.
Hump fires cross court. Good dig. Try the middle again. Not there. Free ball again for the Mustangs. Lucas pushes to the pin, left-handed touch by Ruck. Bump set. McLean can't get it down. Back and forth, and finally, the deep corner try goes a bit wide. Neither team could ever get in system there.
Nope. You know, again, Millard North trying to, again, change things up so they could get organized. It was open, just missed the mark.
Good serve by McLean, and she benefits from the tail of the tape.
Friendly roll.
Bump set, back row attack. McLean tried to keep it up into the antenna and point. On the swing out of the back row by Eve Fountain. Fountain, a six rotation player, quick arm swing, great attack out of the back row. They've used her as more of a DS this year and letting her attack out of the back row as a DS.
You know, and that's the thing too, a lot of players, that selflessness to do, take on a role and do what helps the team in a different capacity. And Eve Fountain has taken that and made a difference.
Second touch. That's a great dump by Grace Goki.
Goki that was very deceptive on that, just lying even as it went over, kind of didn't even catch the attention of the Mustangs until it hit the floor.
Back row again, Fountain is just long.
That was that Holsworth?
That was Holsworth, yep. Now serving is Delaney Hum. Lucan's serve is long, returns the favor. Mm-hmm. Back-to-back service errors. Back in for Pius is Markowski. Tommenheim, a little too tight to the pin, pushes it over. Blocked by the Bolts, Markowski and Tobenheim.
That's quite a pair up at the net, too. Markowski, she works so hard in the middle to get close. She does a great job working pin to pin. Tobenheim standing there at 6-2, 6-3 by Markowski.
Markowski again, powered through the block late, getting there off the hands of McKenna Ruck, and the sophomore for the Thunderbolts provided a bit of a spark off the bench. All even at 14, timeout called by the Mustangs. Here's a look at those headed to college next year to play volleyball from this Pius 10th. Emma Gable is going to walk on right here on this floor. She is the libero for the Thunderbolts, number 5, Morgan Christensen, headed to Fort Hays State. Caitlin Van Cura not playing due to injury. She's going to Benedictine. Delaney Hub at Fort Hays State, and Anna McClain is going to go to Queens University. Queens University in Charlotte, North Carolina, to play volleyball. Great student section here tonight for the Pius 10th Thunderbolts.
Absolutely. Our best of the day, I believe.
Yeah, I would agree. Back to serve now is Morgan Christensen. Ruck. Good swing in the middle. The dig and up by Hum. Free ball here for Millard North. Pushed outside to Ruck again, and that time off the top of the block. And McKenna Ruck with the kill. First team All-State last year.
Ruck, nice high hand shot there.
Ruck was named MVP of the Metro Conference Tournament this year. Also MVP of the Bellevue West Invite. And if you look at PrepDig.com, she's among the top 5 juniors in the state of Nebraska, is McKenna Ruck. Back-to-back points for the Mustangs have put them up by 2. Swing is out, and 3 consecutive here for Millard North. Millard North, the Metro champs this year and last year. Back-to-back Metro champs. T- Tobenheim tips. Bump set by Altman. Point for Pius.
Holsworth catches that tape on that attack.
Back to serve now the setter for the Thunderbolts, senior Grace Gokey. And the kill for the Mustangs, Grant again. Gokey pushes out to McLean. McLean undersized, but has a terrific arm swing.
Great arm swing, and she knows how to tool the block. She just takes her that ball. Look at that swing. She actually falls through, taking it out of bounds, put that spin off the block. There's some power behind that.
Lukens leaves it and long, but they do have a touch.
Yep.
Kill for Grunkmeyer. Grunkmeyer had surgery over the last year where she sat out much of the year. Is finally back and healthy. Be a Hawkeye next year. And the ace. Eva Fountain has just destroyed the Thunderbolts from the service line.
Yes.
She has three aces already here in set one against Pius.
And she, it's just that low flat floater, the movement on the ball. Just really pressing serve receive of the Thunderbolts.
Millard North with three aces in the match, all three from Eve Fountain.
You know, she, as you mentioned, she's taken that role and really embraced it in that back row, kind of being more of that DS position, being an attacker from the back row, adding that element. And again, that's what you need from your players, is come in, you give them a responsibility, they come in and they add to your team.
Well, there's more NSAA High School Championships this month on NET with the best football teams from across the state meet at Memorial Stadium. They will play for state championships. See all of the action on NET Monday the 19th and Tuesday, November 20th. Visit netnebraska.org/sports for the schedule. Live streaming also available at the NET website and on the NET Nebraska app. Eve Fountain off to a fast start from the service line. Better pass there. Goes behind McLean. McLean is blocked. Good coverage. Free ball over. Lukens behind her on the slide. Great up.
Coverage as well.
Coverage provided by Altman. And there's the block.
Huge block there.
Grunkmeyer.
Yep.
Three zip run, 21-16 Millard North, four away from set one.
Another tough serve.
Hannah. There's a better aggressive swing from Hum.
Great job there by Emma Gable. Tough serve, but she gets it in a position for Gokey to make a great set.
Good cover by Hum, behind to McLean. Off the block, McLean goes high hands there and successful.
That's what she's so good at. And it's frustrating to blockers. She just finds your hands and uses you. And when she can, she's gonna bury it because she can get up there and has a lot of power with that arm.
Serve long from Emma Gable. There is Lindsay Peterson, seventh year, third consecutive time in this championship. Off the block and out, the kill by Hum. Pius down by three, but Millard North just three away from set number one. McLean back to serve. Tough serve from McLean. Ruck into the block. Tobenheim got a hand on it. Free ball for the Bolts. Off the top of the tape, and Tobenheim gets the kill.
Actually, I believe that's Christensen.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Yep. Christensen on the slide.
Yep, on the slide.
And a timeout taken by Lindsey Peterson. Both teams now out of timeouts here in set number one. 3-0 run for the Thunderbolts to pull back to within one. Move, counter move here early on. Mm-hmm. Both teams with runs to keep it close and take a lead. Oh, we talked about the Pius 10th Thunderbolts commits. How about the collegiate commits for the Mustangs? Look at this. Allie Kearns is headed north to Sioux Falls. Emmy Grant south to Northwest Missouri State. Grunkmeyer. See, I'm good with directions. East to Iowa, right? Paige Holdsworth will go to Bellevue University. Izzy Lukens, the setter, to Arkansas State. And we heard about McKenna Ruck, who's had a lot of opportunity, a lot of offers, but is going to stay in town and go to UNO.
That's a program, too, that has continued to develop and get some good recruits and starting to see progress in the development of that program.
Drive deep corner, great touch. Lukens with the heads-up play. Saw the opening and put it down. Back to a two-point lead.
Lukens, nice placement. Tobenheim is trying to pursue that ball, making her move to the outer edge. Is tough ball.
Block kept it alive off the swing of Hum, but not that one, as Ruck has another kill. Ruck with 5 kills here in set number one, and Millard North set point. Opportunity right here, out of the back row, swing.
Tough ball.
And the kill. Millard North takes set number one here in the Class A Finals. 25-21 Mustangs. Early lead here for the champs.
The money that comes from Constellation goes directly back into our county 4-H program. So they're directly impacting young people and the development of young people, whether that's leadership development, citizenship development, or helping them develop life skills.
Constellation provides natural gas for Nebraska homes, farms, ranches, and businesses. Through our support for 4-H and FFA, we're providing energy for Nebraska's future as well. Natural gas from Constellation.
Pride of place is more than just a saying. It's a movement driven by a desire to achieve and the unwavering faith of the fans. Like a town and its team, Farmers Mutual of Nebraska, always alongside you.
The Nebraska Chiropractic Physicians Association is pleased to sponsor the NSAA Academic All-State Award Program, recognizing students and athletes who shine in the classroom and on the field. This statewide program recognizes academic excellence, leadership, and athletic achievement in over 20 high school sports and activities. We honor these exceptional students and all of the teachers, coaches, and parents who have mentored them. Together, we can continue to make Nebraska a great place to live, learn, and play.
Nebraska's rich history of high school sports is alive at the Nebraska High School Sports Hall of Fame.
Interactive exhibits bring the action to life. Historic memorabilia preserve the rich heritage, recognizing teams, athletes, coaches, administrators, and community members. The Nebraska High School Sports Hall of Fame in the NSAA headquarters just north of Haymarket Park at 500 Charleston Street in Lincoln. More at nebhalloffame.org.
Welcome back to the Bob Devaney Sports Center here at the Class A State Championship match. Millard North takes set one, 25-21. I'm on the Pius side with Andy Markowski, father of Alexis. And Andy, it's got to be pretty neat for you as a former athlete yourself, former Husker basketball player. You played in the Bob. Now you get to watch your daughter in the Bob. What's it like?
No, absolutely. You know, 20 years ago was the last time I've been this nervous in this facility, but it's certainly exciting. Pius has had a great year. They've got a great group of upperclassmen, and fortunately a little short on set one, but we'll see how this one plays out.
And Alexis, only a sophomore, gets to play in a state championship. You said you never had the opportunity to play in a state championship in basketball or football.
No, not in high school. So the NSAA does such a great job hosting these events. I mean, this is awesome. And I told her last night, I said, you know, don't take this for granted. This might be the last time you get an opportunity to win a championship. You might play for 10 or you might play for one, but you know, they're going to make the most out of it. And, you know, it's been fun to follow the season, and hopefully they can play a little better in the set two.
And what's it like just to see the support from Lincoln and Pius? You know, a Class A Lincoln team has a one in 20 years, but Pius fans showed out tonight.
Yeah, you know, Pius is such a great school, and they're about the total academic and athletic experience. And I was relatively new to volleyball, so when I read the stat that Lincoln hadn't played for it since 2001, and certainly 1998 was the last time they won, it just speaks to the great season that Pius has had this year.
Andy, we appreciate it. Alexis, a sophomore for the Bolts, receiving college interest in basketball and volleyball, has not decided where she will play yet.
Thanks very much, Ryan. I have a reason to not have a voice. I'm wondering what Andy's what Andy's is. You maybe have been screaming a few days.
I was gonna say, that's a dad voice,
that's
it right. Sounds like.
That's right. I will tell you, Andy, it's good to know that Alexis gets all of her athletic ability from her mother. Outstanding athlete. She has already have college basketball offers from South Dakota State and UNO. Obviously, those offers, as she continues to move through her high school career, will grow. She probably has some offers in volleyball as well, has a decision to make in the future.
Nice to have choices.
That's right. 3-1 here early on in set number two. Back to serve is Morgan Christensen.
Great reaction there, just to keep that ball alive by Lucan.
Tobenheim off the block. Lukens, good swing in the middle, and Lukens with the kill. Check that.
Holsworth.
That was Grant, it was a Holsworth with the kill.
Yep, Holsworth.
Good serve, overpass, opportunity here for the Mustangs to even it up. And they do, Holdsworth again. Block didn't quite close and we're even at three.
Actually on the way down maybe a little bit early and pulled it right down with them. Great quick transition. Back up in that middle. Grant right there. Look how quick she is, just that one step and she's up.
Miscommunication. 5-3 lead here for the Mustangs.
Kearns, it's tough here at the service line, putting a lot of pressure on the serve receive.
Tobenheim, just a little roll shot off the side of the block. Back to even.
Tobenheim really hasn't had very many opportunities to really cut loose and drive to the ball. She is a phenomenal attacker. She's been pulled off the net and not had the ball in a great position for her to really show what she's capable of doing.
And Tobenheim again, back-to-back kills for Lauren Tobenheim, the junior outside for Pius. Tobenheim has several offers, not committed yet to a school, would like to play volleyball at the next level.
Keeping her options open, and again, seeing what's out there. Great up there by, Gable. Markowski, good push there, but Millard North ready.
Back row hum, not there. On the second touch, not there. Good coverage. And the point on the longest rally of the match to the Mustangs. Emma Gable, though, with some nice defense here.
I mean, we're talking a power shot that that young lady gets under, absorbs, keeps alive. As we mentioned, she is walking on to Nebraska. She'll probably see more shots like that.
Markowski into the block, and Paige Holdsworth shuts it down along with Emma Grunkmeyer.
Holdsworth really pushing that ball in, does a great job getting to that outside and then pressing back to the center of the court. Good work.
Good turn by Emma McClain.
She just gets up and she's aggressive. Fun to watch. They use her here in the middle. They run Markowski around the backside, making those blockers commit one-on-one.
Up there, read the block, turned the hand away and went away.
Talk about turning away.
Yeah, no kidding, Grunkmeyer with the kill. 8-6 Mustangs.
Blockers off to her left, she takes it hard to the right.
Overpass put down by Lukens.
Lukens aggressive up there at the net as it pops back to her. Throwing it hard to the floor.
Lukens has been the starting setter for Millard North since her freshman year.
Just a junior, so she's been a part of the state championship match run. Been running the offense.
Led her team to a state title in her freshman year.
Pretty impressive.
Runner-up last year, broken several records already at Millard North. Off the block, the tool of the block, and Ruck again.
Ruck going at McLean, using those hands.
Oh, what a great shot there by McLean. Did not look like she could take it that direction and found a way to get it there.
What she does so well is get her shoulder on the ball, and that gives her options, and then just again what she does with the arm, the wrist, to place that ball. But she's so physically strong with that shoulder as well.
Ruck in the middle, that's a great quick set from Lukens. Not much you're gonna do to stop that.
Nope, fast, quick. Just that tempo is hard to stop. Blockers don't have time to move, you just gotta happen to be in the right place.
Goki.
Great up.
Left it for Christensen, not down.
And wide.
Wide on the swing.
Great up there by Holdsworth. You see that tough ball. Look at that full extension out, popping that ball up. Love to see that.
Bump set back to a Tobenheim. Tobenheim with the good angle and gets a kill.
Tobenheim really could drive to that ball, got a nice swing on it. She's got such a quick arm swing, and that high contact point really helps too. We've seen a couple of those.
Yes, we have.
Second service ace for Pius.
Down in the middle of the swing by Grant. Tobenheim kept alive, joust at the net. Good pullback by Lukens. Ruck looked deep corner, not there. Good pass. Tip drive, kept up by Kearns.
Both teams, great defense, working.
And off the tape and down the kill out of the back row from Holdsworth.
Holdsworth's seventh kill. That one, again, just enough spin on that ball. With a Mustang advantage.
Taubenheim tried deep, good up by Ruck, and then the overpass put down by Christensen.
Popped it right up there, Christensen, in that nice base, hands high. That ball comes up. Look at her get right back in there, ready.
Now back to serve is Christensen. Great pass. Solo block. Markowski got a hand on it.
Great adjustment. She reaches across, saw the approach. Her feet weren't quite there, but those hands, look at that, definitely were there.
Drives it right through the block. And another swing and kill by Holdsworth, who's been big. Allie Kearns now back to serve. Down the line, what a shot by Taubenheim.
That's what we were talking about. You get her ball and let her cut loose. She is dynamic. That line is open and she just buries it down the line.
Gilkey with the serve. Gill in the middle by Grunkmeyer.
Just a little bit low. I think that would have been a little higher. Grunkmeyer could have got on top of it, trying that low flat. Trying to beat the block with that quick tempo. It's Fountain made a difference in set number one.
Solo Grunkmeyer block.
Grunkmeyer was solid and all over McLean on that one. McLean, they utilize her in the middle there. They bring her around and try and run Markowski around the backside just to catch you off guard and pull that middle. Nothing doing with Grunkmeyer.
Fire with the touch. McLean off the block. Good cover provided by Gopi. Tried line, no touch point for the Mustangs.
Trying to catch those hands. Was not able to do so.
Another run at the service line for Eve Fountain. Pius has had a hard time in this rotation.
Mm-hmm. They got a great front row. Just that serve has been really limiting. Net
in the net for Pius. And the Bolts will take a timeout. Three straight here for the Mustangs. Make it four in a row. Pius had led 14-13. Now 17-14. Millard North. Coverage of the 2018 NSAA High School Volleyball Championships on NET is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Nebraska Methodist College, Aurora Cooperative, Education Quest, Nebraska Public Power District, Doan University, and Constellation. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. We talked about the history of Millard North and the Mustangs' third consecutive trip here to the finals. It's a rich volleyball tradition also at Pius 10th. Former head coach Jake Moore led the Bolts to seven state championships. Starting back in 1996, they won it in 96, 97, 98, and then went on a run where they won 4 in 6 years. 2006, 7, 8, and 11. Those were the years when it was Pius, Grand Island Northwest.
Yes.
Or Gretna. Was it Gretna at the time?
Gretna was, yeah. Yes, yes, yes.
One of those three teams was in about every year in those early 2000s.
Northwest.
Diana Rose, she had her team back down here again this year. Lost in the first round in Class B to Elkhorn South. Off the top of the block. And the kill by Ruck again.
Number eight for Ruck. She's hitting about 375.
Off the top of the block, not down by Hum. Deep corner try, not there. Taubenheim covers it. Hum again.
Yep.
Off the block and the kill again by McKenna Ruck.
Great push, great tempo to the outside. A position that Ruck could really drive and take, look at that shoulder right on the ball and drives it down the line.
Timeout called by the Thunderbolts. The 37-2 Mustangs in control here, 20-15. We talked about the tradition at Pius 10th Volleyball, started by Jake Moore. There's a look at the history. Let's go down to the floor. Ryan Mix has more.
Yeah, guys, I was able to visit with Jake Moore earlier today. He works the state championships for the NSAA as a court director. And Katie Wenz, in her first year on the job at Pius, unfortunately saw the Bolts' 20-year streak snap of reaching the state tournament. So that was tough for Katie to deal with in her first year. And she leaned on Jake as a mentor. Jake said that he really helped her create and develop a culture and was more than happy to help out. He also gave her some tips on some drills to work with the girls, and obviously it's paid off. Jake is an associate AD at Pius, so he's still around the girls every day, and even though he's not the head coach, still wanted to remain a part of the program.
Yeah, that's true, Ryan. He'd prefer if you called him Gerald. his name is Gerald Moore.
Earth.
Some people call him Jake, but I think most of his friends and those know him well, we call him Gerald. He likes that. Tip at the net and down, and extending that lead. It's a 5-0 run now for Millard North.
Just being aggressive up there at the net. Millard North really clamping down on McLean on that last attack.
Hum again, line. And
there's the shot.
There's the kill by Hum.
Gave her a line, and she takes advantage of that. Hum doing a nice job getting the ball back in the hands of Pius.
Hum's father is Dave Hum, not the former Nebraska quarterback Dave Hum, but she does say that her father was named after the Nebraska quarterback Dave Hum. Dave Hum is at home saying, oh my gosh, how old am I? And your father is named after me. Sorry about that, Dave.
Don't start doing the math. Just
that's right.
Just go with it.
Aggressive swing by Ruck. And the tool of the block, Hum coming alive.
Hum tooling the block. Lukens up there and using that outside hand as a target.
Quick timeout taken by Lindsey Peterson before the Pius run gets away. They still lead by 3, 21-18. An important set number two for both of these teams. Mustangs would love to go up.
Yep.
2-0, give themselves a little bit of breathing room. Pius would like to regain some of that momentum. Josie Gable. They apparently love Josie Gable. Emma Gable is the senior. Josie Gable, a sophomore DS for Pius. That's maybe the best student section we've seen today. A lot of students showing up.
And a lot of, again, organized and coordinated cheering and support for these ladies. It always adds to the element, again, having a fun student section here. And we've really seen, you know, again, coordination of cheers and chants and having fun with each other and doing it in a positive way.
Millard North students with the whiteout. So now serving for Pius is Emma Gable. 8 digs for the future Husker. Gable's serve is long. Couple of service errors for Gable. back to serve now for the Mustangs is Emma Altman. McLean, no touch and long. And unforced errors piling up here for the Thunderbolts.
Well, I'm trying to work around the block, and you know, there McLean trying to find the hands and get that to go out of bounds off the hands, just missed the hands. Those, like you said, start adding up.
Yep. And home there, into the net, didn't clear. Three consecutive service error, two hitting errors.
Now we're at set point.
Opportunity here for the Mustangs to go up 2-0. And the block kept alive.
Great coverage.
And then the unforced error. So the Mustangs close it out in set number two. Mustangs on top. 2-0 in the Class A title. We'll see if they can pull off the sweep when we come back.
Head trauma and concussion risk minimization is a priority of the NSAA. When in doubt, sit them out.
Some common symptoms of concussions are dizziness, confusion, and nausea.
The NSAA requires coaches in all sports to take a concussion course annually.
For more information regarding concussion management and return to play protocol, visit our website, nsaahome.org. When in doubt, sit them out.
Early mornings, late nights. Emotionally, physically, mentally tougher. Generations of trust, innovation, and hard work done side by side. The decisions you make for your land and livestock have a direct impact on your operation, the region, and the world. That is why we're there when you need us anytime, every time. We both have one chance, one season, one mission. Tougher together. Aurora and you.
For me, asking why is just getting started.
It's more than an activity. It's me doing what I love.
I'm not a stereotype. When I rewrite the rules, things get better.
I know that all these experiences matter.
These moments will help me become something more.
Little things always lead to something bigger.
Do it.
Track it.
Earn it.
What you're doing now will help you get scholarships later. Find resources from Education Quest at trackyoursuccess.org.
Let's talk about public power for a second. Nebraska's electric utilities use a diverse mix of fuel resources to generate electricity. Wind, water, coal, nuclear, natural gas, solar, and methane. Just another way your electric utility shows how public power works for you. Let's talk about public power for a second. Did you know Nebraska's electric utilities pay more than $100 million to communities they serve each year? Those dollars stay local, helping to empower our hometowns. Just another way your electric utility shows how public power works for you.
Welcome back to the Bob Devaney Sports Center Class A State Championship match. Millard North off to a 2-0 lead. The Mustangs entering competition 37-2. More than happy to have senior middle blocker Emma Grunkmeyer back. The Hawkeye commit had back surgery in May. She had three fractured vertebrae, did not return to volleyball activities until September, and that was on a limited basis. She played in 15 matches this season, but this is the first time she faced off against Lincoln Pius X. Lindsay Peterson, head coach at Millard North, said that Grunkmeyer took on a coaching type of role when she was out, and when she returned, you could instantly feel the energy. Grunkmeyer, kind of an X factor tonight for the Mustangs.
No doubt about it, as is Molly Plain, who puts that down. Molly Plain, a junior middle. Lukens now back to serve for the Mustangs. Christensen in the middle with the kill.
Here you see Christensen's got two blockers. She turns it, takes it away, finds the floor. Every matching here. Swing for swing. In the middles.
Bit of unfamiliar territory here for the Thunderbolts. Who have won 27 matches in a row. Last time they lost was to Papillion La Vista. Lost earlier this year to Millard North. And the ace.
just some communication again and backing off. Tough serves, but again, players need to just talk to one another. Be aggressive. Oh.
Back-to-back aces. That off the tape and down. And Ruck gives Millard North a 4-1 lead here in the third. Here's another look at it.
Just catching that tape. We've seen that several times. Server serving low, trying to get that ball just to graze across the top of the tape. When it hits, it's just the luck of the draw. It goes over, and you just got to react to it and try and make a save on it.
Good student section on hand tonight from Millard North as well. Good win for the Huskers today here in Lincoln, knocking off the Fighting Illini, so you can get in the game on Tuesday on NET World. The Big Red wrap-up looks back at today's game against the Fighting Illini. Nebraska 54-35 win. Watch the Cornhusker State's most interactive sports show, Big Red Wrap-Up, Tuesday night at 7 Central on NET World. And again, 10 on NET. McKenna Ruck with back-to-back aces now. Six aces in the match for the Mustangs. And the block on the slide to Markowski. Block was just sitting there waiting for that one.
Yeah, Pius has just been struggling to get that offense going, making some hitting errors to close out set number two. There's a pass. And there's a block.
Down 5-2 here in the third. Bolts need to get something going. Two sweeps already today. Bergen with the sweep in class D1. Scott with the sweep in class B.
Then we've had some other
2-5 setters, yeah.
Incredible.
Open up the day with an 18-16 final in class D2. BDS knocking off Ewing. And we had a 5-setter. Wahoo won its second straight state championship, 15-10. In the fifth over Lincoln Lutheran.
That ball popped up to Markowski, and she took care of business, getting a little energy and excitement on the Thunderbolt side.
Outside of the antenna, the set too tight. Not much Taubenheim could do with that.
Blockers there, but again, just a ball is pushed wide. Taubenheim just trying to get her hand on the ball.
Goki to Markowski, who rolls it over. Aggressive swing there from Holdsworth, and Holdsworth with the kill.
Holdsworth has just been steady and consistent. That's her 10th kill. She's leading all attackers. With those, that 10.
Lindsey Peterson calls Holdsworth the most consistent attacker on this Mustang team. Wow. McLean wrapped up and fired, and it was Grunkmeyer there to shut it down. That was a big swing and a bigger block.
It came down as fast as it went into that block. It was like hitting the wall.
Yeah, those are the ones that feel good.
Yes.
And the ace, 7 aces. And right now, Pius just being run off the court.
Just a lot of unforced errors, really. And the block and serve has definitely been a plus.
Another ace, 5-zip run here for Millard North. Pius will sub here.
Trying to get something different. That's a fourth ace of this set for the Mustangs. So really pressuring the serve receive of Pius.
Nice serve. 8 aces already in the match for Millard North. Great service run. Back to serve now for Pius. Here's Taubenheim. Good dig by Gable. Aggressive swing off the block and out. Hum with the kill.
Grunkmeyer there, Hum used her this time. It's a tough one to get around, so you've got to find ways to tool off of it.
It's a good up by Gable. Again off the block and out. Back-to-back kills on that left side by Delaney Hum.
I'm just being smart, seeing what she's got in front of her.
Into the net. Into the game for Pius in the front row is Carly Rodaway. Number 16, a 6-foot junior. Rodaway, the daughter of Brian Rodaway, who played baseball at Lincoln High, went on to play baseball at Nebraska. Very good lefty on some of those good Nebraska baseball teams. Went on to have a brief professional career.
Job there by Rodaway.
Back to within three.
Steps in and adjusts. That ball was inside. She sees Holsworth coming in. That's what you want, a player to come in and be a difference maker. Be a spark.
Wide. 11-9. I just got a text from Gerald Moore. He said, you are in so much trouble.
Great up there. And scrappy play right now. There's a big swing.
Boy, she has been big at big moments. Holdsworth with another kill. That is why Lindsey Peterson calls her the most consistent attacker on this team.
You just love that stability, you know, that it presents to a team.
Pius had closed to within two. Holdsworth stops the run, but then good swing there by the lefty, Carly Rodaway.
Rodaway is doing a tremendous job. She's come in and she's been a spark plug. Got a big block. Here's a nice swing, as you mentioned, that lefty on that right side.
Into the antenna.
Yep.
Now, was it off of the...
The ball, yeah.
Was Miller. It on its way over, or was it after it touched Izzy Lukens? And the Here. Officials are going to get together.
We'll get a chance to.
Well, it did not hit the antenna on the first touch. Highest point. Another look at it. Huh.
Yeah. Yep, just a little wiggle of that antenna as she tried to push it back in.
Swing just long from Hum. Back to serve now is Emma Altman. Back to Hum again. Tried deep corner, got it. Great shot by Hum. And Delaney Hum having a nice set number three. She'll go back to serve.
Yep, good surge here by making some good decisions. She's tooled the block here. She found the open area of the court, and it's really just about control and placement of the ball.
Down the line and in. What a swing.
Ruck made her presence known up there in the front row. Definitely drives that ball. Look at that, right down that line. Very difficult for a defender.
10 kills in the match now for Ruck. Christensen answers.
You see just a little bit of energy here. Energizing the Bolts.
Back to serve now is Christensen. Confusion, miscommunication, and it drops. Even at 14. And Peterson will take a timeout. First timeout here of set number three for Lindsey Peterson's squad. And what a run of aces here for this Mustang team. Pius finally answers with one of its own. So you saw the ace there by the Thunderbolt, but the real key here in set number three has been the aces from the Mustangs.
Yeah, Eve Fountain has done a tremendous job driving that ball. I believe she has three herself in this match.
Yep, three for Fountain, two for Molly Plain, and two for McKenna Ruck. McKenna Rucks were back to back, right?
Yep.
There was one of them. And Molly Plain.
Thing you can really control a team with your a tough serve, limit their offensive options, and kind of put doubt in the feet in the serve receive. Wow,
great set and deliver on the kill from Emmy Grant. What a touch over the head.
Great, great decision. Everything you can see leaning to the right side of the court, left that whole third on that left side of the court.
Point for Millard North. Now back to serve for the Mustangs. Molly Plain. Plain with two aces already here in the match. And the service error. Well, Bolts trying to get something going here in set three. Into the antenna. That'll be a point for Millard North.
Tough ball there, Hum, taking that, coming right over the top of her. And tight. See the angle she gets that. Doesn't give her much to work with either, as it landed right tight at the net.
Stay in ball.
And another ace. That is the third for Ruck. No, check that. That is that was a Ruck. That was four for Fountain.
Yep, four for Fountain.
Ruck was dancing. We looked back.
Yeah. Shoe tie here. That's what a little delay. There's another round.
Wow. Five aces in the match for Eve Fountain. And at least two of those have gone off the tape and dropped. in this set alone. Millard North with six aces. Home with a good swing. Fountain kept it alive. Free ball over. Good pass. Goki behind her. Rodaway couldn't get it down.
Yep. Oh, Holdsworth.
When you need it, Holdsworth is there.
Holding steady, four in a row.
Four zip run for Millard North. The Bolts had pulled back to even. And the Mustangs looking for the sweep now, five away. North on top, two zip in the match. So let's see if the timeout from Katie Witz will help the Bolts get back into this. They're going to need a run here, down by four, and Millard North just five away. I want to remind you, good time for you to pick up a DVD of tonight's game from the NSAA High School State Championships. You can call 800-868-1868. Again, that's 800-868-1868, 1995, plus shipping and handling. You have a copy of these state high school championships. Fountain to serve again. Block back, kept alive. Another aggressive swing by Holdsworth, still in. Deep corner, good coverage by Tobenheim. Hum into the block.
Still alive.
Good up by Fountain. Bump set. Good dig, second touch. And finally, Markowski with the touch and the point for the Bolts.
I'm giving Emma Gable a huge thumbs up with that big dig. She popped that ball right up. All over the floor in coverage.
See why John Cook excited to have her walk on. Good athlete, good size, very quick.
Grunkmeyer being aggressive up at the net. As you mentioned, just a definite plus to that lineup when she was available.
Good up by Fountain.
Again. She's doing a great job in the back row.
Lindsay Peterson said she had transitioned to a DS in the back row and hitting out of that back row, and she has really delivered here tonight, as have Hum. Hum's been big.
Yes, Hum right here has that opening and she fires it through. That's her 10th kill. Leading all the Thunderbolts.
Off the top of the block by Christensen.
Grunkmeyer, I believe.
And Grunkmeyer now just three away. And the Mustangs.
Christensen swinging away up at the front, keeping the pressure on. Wow.
What a swing by Ruck.
Did she get on top of that ball?
Ruck just pounds that.
No doubt.
Two away from a state championship for Millard North. Deliver to the middle.
Grant, one away.
championship point for the Mustangs. Taubenheim with the kill. Pius 10th survives the first championship point. Here's the second. Lukens, middle. Off the block and out. The Mustangs, Class A state champs. Complete performance for the Mustangs.
Just came in and were consistent throughout. We had tight, but when they really needed it, they pushed through. I mean, talk about the consistency of Holsworth, Ruck coming up with big, with some big swings as well. Just a complete game all the way around. Tough serving.
Right.
Got to credit a lot of serving.
Second title in as many years, in 3 years. Second title in 3 years for the Mustangs, third consecutive time they've been here in the state championship. Congratulations to Lindsay Peterson and her squad. Gruckmeyer goes out a state champ, as does Holsworth. Millard North Mustangs take home the Class A title in a sweep of Pius the 10th. When we come back, medal and trophy presentations right here on NET Sports.
FFA's vision is to build leaders, grow communities, and strengthen agriculture. The funds from Constellation will most likely be directed to one of those areas. But most importantly, people need to know that it is at the local level. It's helping local chapters.
Constellation provides natural gas for Nebraska homes, farms, ranches, and businesses. Through our support for 4-H and FFA, we're providing energy for Nebraska's future as well. Natural gas from Constellation.
Earning my shield means...
It means I'm always moving forward.
Never stopping, always learning.
It means rising to the challenge of my ambition.
Earning my shield means having the confidence to hold my own with anyone from anywhere.
It means more opportunities for me and my children.
Earning my shield means
it's never too early or late to set goals. What does it mean to earn your shield? I found out it don't.
You are a Nebraska farmer. You defined tough. You pushed the limit. You gave it all you had. And when you got to the end of the field, you turned around and we were there behind you every step of the way. Our success is measured by our understanding of your farm. It is measured in your trust in us at Aurora Cooperative. Tougher together, Aurora and you.
Coverage of the 2018 NSAA High School Volleyball Championships on NET is made possible in part by Nebraska Soybean Board, Nebraska Methodist College, Aurora Cooperative, Education Quest, Nebraska Public Power District, Doan University, and Constellation. A big thank you to all of our sponsors who help us bring you the best high school athletes from across the state. We could not do it without your support. Back at the Bob Devaney Sports Center in Lincoln, your state champs in Class A, the Mustangs of Millard North. Time now for medal and trophy presentations. But before that, some special awards for good sportsmanship. Let's go down to Steve Lemon.
The Nebraska School Activities Association, the Nebraska Coaches Association, and the Nebraska Athletic Administrators Association are proud to support and promote positive sportsmanship during the state championships and throughout the season. At this time, we are pleased to present the Sportsmanship Award for Class A. The trophy is graciously donated by Awards Unlimited. The Class A Sportsmanship Award winner is Lincoln Pius the 10th High School. Congratulations, Lincoln Pius the 10th High School. The Nebraska School Activities Association is honored to have medals and trophies for both of these outstanding teams. Presentations will be made by NSAA Executive Director Jay Beller. NSAA Board of Directors Kathy Wieskamp from Lincoln Public Schools, Tommy Lee from Omaha Northwest, and U.S. Bank Representative Malia Headley. Here are the awards for runner-up Lincoln Pius X High School. Coach Katie Wentz and her assistants will present the silver medals. Players, please come forward as your name is called. Number two, Cora Thomas. Number six, Riley Kenobi. Number seven, Josie Gable. Number nine, Lauren Tobenheim. Number 10, Miriam Miller. Number 11, Kylan Seelock. Number 12, Alexis Markowski. Number 16, Carly Rodaway. And the seniors, number four, Grace Goki. Number five, Emma Gable. Number eight, Morgan Christensen. Number 13, Caitlin Ventura. Number 14, Delaney Hum. And number 15, Anna McLean. For these outstanding athletes and their school, here is the 2018 NSAA Class A State Volleyball Runner-Up Trophy. Congratulations, Lincoln Pius X High School. And now to the champions, Millard North High School. Head coach Lindsey Peterson, we have a special award for you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Coach Peterson and her assistants will present the gold medals. Players, please come forward as your name is called. Number four, Molly Plain. Number seven, Lauren Macheski. Number nine, London Emmons. Number 11, Eve Fountain. Number 15, Izzy Lucas. Number 16, McKenna Rock. And now the seniors. Number one, Haley Moshka. Number two, Allie Kearns. Number three, Emmy Grant. Number eight, Emma Altman. Number 10, Marissa Solber. Number 13, Emma Grunkmeyer. And number 14, Paige Holdsworth. Presenting the championship game ball from Farmers Mutual Insurance, Regional Director of Agencies, Tim Below. And now for these outstanding athletes in their school, here is the 2018 NSAA Class A State Volleyball Championship Trophy. Congratulations, Millard North High School.
They are the state champs again for the second time in 3 years. The Mustangs will take home the trophy. Congratulations to head coach Lindsay Peterson and her Mustangs. State champs once again. She let them know it. State champs from Millard North. We'll hear from them when we come back.
Pride of place is more than just a saying. It's a movement, driven by a desire to achieve and the unwavering faith of the fans. Like a town and its team, Farmers Mutual of Nebraska, always alongside you.
The Nebraska Chiropractic Physicians Association is pleased to sponsor the NSAA Academic All-State Award Program, recognizing students and athletes who shine in the classroom and on the field. This statewide program recognizes academic excellence, leadership, and athletic achievement in over 20 high school sports and activities. We honor these exceptional students and all of the teachers, coaches, and parents who have mentored them. Together, we can continue to make Nebraska a great place to live, learn, and play.
I like to let my daughter online to the PBS website because she enjoys Daniel the Tiger and Dinosaur Train. I trust those programs because they're very kid-friendly. They're also age-appropriate.
August, which shows do you watch on PBS Kids? Wild Kratts. Is that your favorite? Hazel, which is your favorite? Daniel Tiger.
I like NET because it reaches any income, low or high, approaches kids from any background. We like to watch Peck Plus Cat, The Wild Kratts, Dinosaur Train.
I like to watch Art Squad.
They are learning for him how to share and how to interact with other kids and solve problems.
My name is Teresa Martinez.
We're the Heinrichs family.
And we watch PBS Kids.
And support NET.
Welcome back to the Bob Devaney Sports Center here with the Class A state champs, Millard North, and head coach Lindsay Peterson. Coach, a sweep of the nationally ranked Pius Thunderbolts. I'm not sure any of us expected that. Did your team expect that coming?
I think we knew coming in that it was going to be a tight game. We expected it to be a tight game, but I knew if they came out and played the way I knew they can play and they played together, that there was a shot. And so I'm just overwhelmed and extremely proud of what they did tonight.
Your team was full of upperclassmen. In fact, everyone on varsity was a junior or senior. Seven seniors on the roster. How beneficial was that for the senior leadership and for those girls who had been in the state championship match?
It made a huge difference. The second we stepped in the Metro tournament, I felt like the seniors just took over. And what's awesome is that you feel like at that point they're coaching your team. I mean, and they listen and they do what they're supposed to be doing. And I just feel like when they took over, there was nobody that was going to stop us.
And no one was stopping your serves. You guys had 10 aces tonight, which is pretty remarkable for a state championship. And Eve Fountain alone had five. Pretty remarkable.
Eve is an awesome server. She's even better in the front row. This year we used her as a role in the back row, and she did extremely well. She played her role well, and she serves a bullet.
25-21, 25-18, 25-20. I mean, they were all competitive sets, but none that, you know, went the distance or that you guys really had to sweat out. So what did you think was the difference in you guys comfortably winning in three sets?
A little experience. But we executed. We executed very well. We had a game plan coming in. They did what they were asked. And even when we were out of system, we put aggressive balls over the net. And then that made us successful.
So, Coach, two out of three for you guys. And prior to 2016, it had been almost 20 years since Millard North had won a state championship. Now you guys are getting into the habit of this.
Yeah, it's pretty fun. I'm not going to lie to you.
All right. Well, let's bring in McKenna Ruck. junior for the Mustangs, who finished with 11 kills, hit an impressive 348, 12 digs as well for you. So, McKenna, this is the second time you get to hold this trophy. How does that feel?
It feels amazing. This time I don't have the trophy in front of my face, so that's a little bit better. But, yeah, the second time is even better.
What did you think was the difference? Was it the experience, or were you guys just so poised out there that Pius, who hadn't played in a state championship match, do you think your experience carried over?
You know, it was a little bit of both. I feel we were very experienced, but every day and at practice we worked our butts off, and that paid off in the long run.
So you take the first set, 25-21. Second set, as a team, you guys hit 342. Extremely impressive. What was it like after that second set going up 2-0? Did you feel like you guys had a lot of momentum on your side?
Yeah, we just wanted to get the game over with. We wanted to get a sweep. That'd be nice. And going into the third set, we just wanted to continue what we were doing in the first and second set and continue that momentum.
Well, you got the sweep. Yep. So it was nice for you guys, and you get to come back next year. Mm-hmm. You think it's possible for you to be standing here again next season?
Yeah, I would think so. Hopefully. I think we'll have a lot of people returning, and we'll have a bunch of great players still returning, so we got a good chance.
All right, let's bring in Paige Holdsworth, a senior for Miller North. She finished with a team high 12 kills and 9 digs. Paige, you guys were outstanding this year, school record 38 wins, but Pius was actually nationally ranked ahead of you guys. So they were in the top 15 in Max Preps and USA Today. For you guys to sweep them, what does that say about the strength of your team?
I mean, it says that we just give it all we got, and that's that. We come out with a game plan and we execute.
The 10 aces, how much of a difference was that today?
It was huge. When you miss serves, I mean, that comes into play more than we think. So with the aces, it just helps out with our defense.
Talk a little bit about Coach Peterson and the impact and the influence that she's had on this team.
I think she's motivated us a lot throughout the years, especially us seniors. She knows when it's time for us to step up, and she got us this year.
Playing on the big stage in the Devaney Sports Center, second time in 3 years you guys win it, third year in a row, though, that you are here. Do you think that Miller North is really starting to build something pretty strong as a volleyball program?
I think definitely. I think younger girls will see the talent that we've had, and they'll recognize that they're capable of the same talent, and they'll want to be a part of it.
Well, Paige, congratulations. An exciting time to be a Miller North Mustang. They win their second state championship in 3 years as they sweep Lincoln Pius X in the Class A final.
Well, thank you very much, Ryan, and congratulations to Millard North. Here's a look then at the final six champions that were all crowned today. We started this morning, hard to believe, we started at 9 a.m. this morning. BDS wins it over Ewing. We thought that might set the tenor of what was going to be a great day, and it really did. That was an 18-16 in the fifth. BDS wins it. Archbishop Bergen wins that school's first ever state championship. The same for Blue Hill. They had never won a state championship. Wahoo, two in a row. Scott Catholic was just dominant in that Class B matchup. And then the same thing here for Millard North, dominant once again.
Millard North came in and again finished the night with a big bang and took charge and gets that second state champion in 3 years.
Kathy, final thoughts. What's going to stick out about this year's state championship?
I would say the talent of the athletes that we had the opportunity to watch today. And again, the team, you know, the how they played within themselves, played as their role, and again, brought the players around them. But again, just the quality of athletes that we're seeing out of the state of Nebraska, 57 going on scholarships to play. And so pretty impressive quality that we're getting to have the opportunity to view each state.
And how about the youth? Okay, we've got some really top shelf talent that are young, and we're going to see next year. Can't wait for that.
We're going to have more to come.
That's right.
More fun. What a great day.
That was a great day here on NET. We want to say thank you to you for joining us right here on NET Sports as we were happy to crown six state champions in the NSAA High School Volleyball Championships in 2018. So one final time, that will do it for us on NET. For Kathy Wieskamp, for Ryan Mix, and for our entire NET Sports production crew that worked so hard throughout the day to bring you these championships, thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you next week back here for the State Football Championships on NET.